I've fallen in love, it will be forever, or I'll never fall in love. In a restless world like this is, love is ended before it's begun, and too many moonlight kisses seem to cool in the warmth of the sun, and the moment that I feel that. When I fall in love with you,
that means it's time for the Romper Room School. And I'm Miss Sherri saying hello to all the boys and girls here and to all my friends at home. Well, good morning, everybody.
Good morning, Sherri.
Hello, David.
Good morning.
How are you down there?
Fine.
Oh, Derek, that's a beautiful bow tie you have on today. Why don't you sit up nice and straight and show the camera? There you go. Good morning, Lauren Marie.
Hey, what about me? I have a bow tie, too.
Oh, Candy Cat, we forgot about you.
Hey, Alex, how are you?
Fine.
Well, I'm ready to sing. Mr. Music? Clap your hands for Candy Cat.
Yeah, kids, yeah. Clap your hands. Hey, yeah, thank you.
That was wonderful.
Well, Miss Sherri, what are you waiting on? Let's go get the cottage cheese. Sunday.
Excuse me. Oh, there it is, an Eden Dairy cottage cheese strawberry sundae. Mmm, so good. Mm. Ask your mom to buy some Eden Dairy cottage cheese and make you a strawberry sundae.
You know what I'd like to do is check in the library and see if they had some stock in that area.
Hi.
Hi, Sherri.
Oh, hi, Mr. Zinner.
I need to ask you, how long is it before you have to stop doing the show?
Oh, 3 months, maybe. Longer, if you don't mind me showing.
I don't mind, but... it's a kid's show, you know how it is.
Oh, sure, I know. We wouldn't want the little darlings to find out where they come from now, would we?
No, we wouldn't.
Hello to Penny for me.
And to Bob.
Okay.
Come on,
let's
go.
Are you something? Brother?
Mary Beth? You want some? Oh. What's the problem?
Nothing.
Oh, sure. Yeah, I can see that. Is there anything I can do?
Oh, no.
Candy Cat, it's tea day, so every word we say has to start with a T. Ta-ta!
Ta-ta!
Today's the day.
Tummy.
Okay, Johnny.
Tiny
here, come
tigers,
on, Johnny. Oh, you can do it.
Come
on, you can do it. Show your mom. Come on.
Joey.
Yeah. Joey in the
lead,
and
here comes Joey. Joey, that is great. Good boy, yeah. You are terrific.
Yay,
Joey.
See that, Mom?
Mark, not while your father's giving lessons.
All right.
We've come a long way, Dottie. We are thrilled. I can't believe it.
Bob is an incredible teacher.
Isn't he?
Yeah. Now, this is for today and
oh, thank you, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. How far along are you? Oh, I can always tell.
Frank wants me to take a group to Europe again.
Dottie Harper guessed I was pregnant. She said she can always tell.
2 weeks in August. Rome, maybe.
I was hoping I could go on doing the show at least a little while longer.
I know I could turn the kids on to Roman history.
If I'd stay behind that desk, I could be giving birth on camera for all they know.
You know, Mikey, you're getting kind of one-track-minded about that show.
Well, honey, I like doing it.
Well, that is a different story. What Mosetti wants, Mosetti gets.
Would you rather I didn't work?
Did I say that? Did I?
All you have to do is tell me.
Did I say that?
Well, sometimes I think you mind me doing a show.
Why should I mind?
Bobby, we were talking.
I was listening.
Yeah, sure you were.
Oh, Bobby.
Mom, can I have some more juice, please?
Is it my birthday?
Just a few more days, Mark.
It's my birthday present.
It's a surprise.
My toast is for
you. Oh, holy smoke. I'm gonna be late.
What's the rush? It's only 7:30.
Is it a schwind?
Is it a schwind, Mom?
A schwind? We can't afford that. I got a meeting.
Well, who's going to take the kids?
Diane will take them, can't she?
Did you call her?
I don't want training wheels.
She doesn't want training wheels, Mom.
I don't want training wheels.
Well, I hope they pay you for all these extra hours you put in. Don't forget the cleaning.
Bye, Dad.
What cleaning?
Bye, Dad.
Bye.
I don't like the yellow ones and the green ones.
Well, honey, just eat the blue and purple.
Okay. I don't want to go to school. Is there any more orange juice? I don't know.
Appeals court rules that Negro James T. Meredith must be admitted
today
to the University of Mississippi.
My husband brought him back from London. He led a school group there this summer.
Governor Ross Barnett has announced he will go to jail himself to uphold the law.
Distaval, D-I-S-T-A-V-A-L.
What law is he supposed to be upholding?
States' rights.
It's a tranquilizer. Mm. Take as needed for sleep. Oh, maybe 30, maybe even a few more than that. I've just been sleeping so badly. Could you? I know it's probably not anything. I just wanted to make sure.
Is smoking a killer?
Yeah. He can call me
God,
back.
God, I hope not.
Mr. Doobie says, do be a car sitter. Don't be a car stander. The boys and girls have drawn some beautiful pictures today. Michael, what are you drawing?
A dog.
A dog. And Mariel, what's that?
A pig.
A pig. Jesse, what animal are you drawing today?
Giraffe.
A giraffe. How do we know it's a giraffe? What's special about a giraffe?
It's got a great big long neck.
A great big long neck?
And it's yellow.
And it's yellow?
With big brown balls.
With big brown?
Balls.
With big brown. Big brown. With spots. It's got big brown spots. That's what they're called.
Oh, it's magic mirror time.
Romper, bumper, stomper, boo. Tell me, tell me, tell me, do. Magic mirror, tell me today. Did all my friends have fun at play? Oh, I see Stevie and Mary. I see Linda and Tommy. And Judy, I hope you're feeling better today.
I mean, is it my fault that Donnie stares at me? I don't ask him to. I hate it. And how am I supposed to say that to Mom? I mean, she married him. He thinks he's this sweet, innocent guy and that it's all my fault. So I tell her, fine, I don't want to be here anymore. And she says, so leave. And I can't, because I don't have any money And I don't know where to go. I mean, I don't know.
Hey, Mary Beth. Are you going out with anybody right now?
I'm sort of dating Kevin.
Well, why don't you have Kevin come around your place more? Would that help?
If you ever tried to have a conversation with Kevin, it's like,
Well, why do you go out with him then?
To keep the others away.
Feel like you belong somewhere else, huh? Another country, another planet, maybe. No one knows what's going on inside you. It sounds like there's no one you can talk to. Some days you think you're gonna be all right, and some days, you just wanna die. Huh? You're not the only one who feels that way, Mary Beth.
You feel that way too?
No, I just mean a lot of people feel that way at certain times. Oh, out of time. Did I help any?
Mm-hmm.
All right. I'll see you in class, okay? Take care.
Thank you.
All right.
Hi.
Hi.
Can I give you a hand?
Yeah, let me get to the other side.
Hey, what, don't you dare. You're the one who's pregnant.
Oh, I'm so jealous. I'd kill to be pregnant.
Oh, come on, Diane. Your kids drive you crazy.
I'm not talking about kids. I just want to be pregnant. Oh, Billy's going to die. You got Mark a Schwinn?
Well, don't tell him because Mark doesn't know yet.
I'm nuts. They know everything. You know, Carol told me this morning that the Beaumonts are getting divorced. Did you know that?
Well, I'd divorce her, too, if I were him. Have you seen the way she looks at Bob?
We all look at Bob that way, haven't you noticed?
I don't know why it drives me crazy, but it does. It's all that extra time he puts in.
He's a really good teacher, Sherri. All the kids say
so. I know. I know. That's what he tells me. Teaching is about caring. Then why do I want to scream every time he says it?
So scream. If it makes you feel any better, scream.
Ow!
Oh.
You said scream.
Okay, goodbye.
Bobby?
What?
That was the doctor. He wants us to come into his office first thing this morning.
What for? Are you sick?
No.
Is one of the kids sick?
No.
Am I sick?
No. Dr. Warner, my doctor.
He wants to see us right away?
Yeah, yeah. I think it's about those tranquilizers you brought back from Europe.
Tranquilizers? What about them?
It's called focomelia. It means seal limbs. Stunted growth in the arms and legs. Thousands of them have been born in Europe. Just about as pure thalidomide. There's a chance that your baby will be born deformed. A high chance. They can live. Well, they can live all right, but they need a lot of help.
Oh. Isn't there anything we could do?
Let me have a word with you outside, Bob. We won't be long, Sherri. All right, this is how it is. The law is the law, and I'm not about to break it. Mm-hmm. But there are ways, and there are ways. Now, what I'm saying is, if you want a termination, I can arrange it. But you've got to keep it quiet.
A termination? How?
Why don't you just leave that to me?
Who would do it?
I would. Here in town,
in Mercy Hospital. I'll tell you this much. If it was my wife, I'd recommend a termination. I would not hesitate.
Yeah. Okay. Let's tell Sherri.
All right.
We can deal with this, Sherri. We can deal with
it. How can we deal with it?
Dr. Warner says that we can arrange a termination, if that's what we want.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I could schedule you into Mercy Hospital for next Wednesday.
That's Mark's birthday.
Ugh, that doesn't matter, honey. How long would it take?
The operation, no time at all. But we'll keep her in the hospital a couple of days.
Schedule it. We can always cancel it if we change our minds, right?
Sure. Now, you've done nothing wrong, Sherri. It's the drug. The drug that's done the damage. So, it's not your fault, right?
Well, we don't have the money for full-time help. You'd have to give up your show. Permanently.
What about the kids?
It'd be fair to them.
Why did you go out of the room with Dr. Warner?
Why did I leave the room?
Yeah, why did you go out of the room?
What do you mean, why did I go out
of
the room?
I'm not a child, Bobby.
I know that.
Then why did you go out of the room?
The doctor asked me to... Honey, I think Dr. Warner was just trying to protect you. That's all.
Only I'm not a child, Bobby. Okay?
Okay.
You scheduled the operation.
Honey, it's what your doctor thinks we should do.
You didn't ask me.
Well, it's just tentative. We don't have to do it.
You didn't. Ask me.
Well, I'm asking you.
You just
now.
Scheduled it.
What is this? Are you trying to tell me you don't want to do it?
No, that's not what I'm trying to tell you.
I don't get it. What's the problem?
What's the problem?
All right, I know what the problem is. I say we do something about it. And forget it and move on with our lives.
You can really do that, can't you? Just move on. Oh, I can't.
Well, you're gonna have to try, Sherri. Otherwise, it's gonna drive you crazy.
He'll do that anyway.
Yeah, exactly. So you're gonna have to learn to shut it off. Just shut it down. Honey, I know you.
Is that what you do?
Yeah?
Understand, darling, if it's not serious, why do you have to go into the hospital?
It's just like a checkup, Mom.
What sort of checkup?
It's nothing. Really, don't worry about it.
If it's nothing, why do you have to go into the hospital? I hate it when people go and see doctors. Russell Golding went to see the doctor and he told Lucy it was nothing. But when he got home, he told her it was cancer. And in 3 months, he was dead.
Nobody has cancer, Mom.
Why can't you tell me? You know I'll imagine the worst if you don't tell me.
I'm pregnant. And there may be a problem with the baby, and they just want to check it out, all right?
You're pregnant?
Yes.
You never told me.
Well, I'm telling you now.
Just as well. You've had enough of that romper show. What sort of problem?
Will you just leave it alone, Mom?
Hello? This is Dr. Anderson, the psychiatrist. Yes. Uh-huh. No, Dr. Werner told us, yeah. What time? Okay. Yeah, I'll tell Sherri. She'll be there. Thanks. Bye.
You know what I hate about it most?
What?
The way it has to be a secret. It's like I'm doing something dirty.
I'm not doing anything dirty.
Then why does it have to be a secret?
Honey, it's against the law.
Then how can Dr. Warner do the operation?
There's ways. There's always ways.
This has happened to other people.
How do I know?
You don't. Everybody keeps it a secret.
Mrs. Finkbine, maybe you would like one. One of my little weaknesses. Please, sit. I'm very sorry about all of this. The way the law is, termination of a pregnancy is a criminal offense. 2 to 5 years in jail, unless the mother is in danger. My job as a psychiatrist is to find out if your pregnancy has you in such stress that you might become emotionally imbalanced and take your own life. You with me so far?
Take my own life? I have 4 small children.
Well, people do some crazy things. You're feeling pretty churned up about this right now, right? You don't sleep? Cry a lot? Feel like crying right now? You feel guilty? You feel like you should be punished? Danger. Self-destructive impulses. You have no idea what you might do. Extreme disintegration of personality. Severe suicidal depression. Recommendation? Therapeutic abortion. That's it. Everything's going to be just fine.
Everybody knows
that's
it.
Right.
You should have the evening show.
Oh, you should.
I'm going to go talk to Pete about it right now.
Good for you. And I want to know why I'm never in your magic mirror.
Well, I didn't know you cared. Tomorrow morning you will be.
I see, Tommy.
When you have time to watch the show, don't you have work to do?
You're our number one pinup in the newsroom.
Oh,
God. Look at all the shoes. I want that with one rock or two. You're a big one for you, right?
You at Channel 9?
Where's your wife?
Nope.
You looking to get lucky here?
Me neither. Tom Crawford, Arizona Republic.
Bob Finkbine, Montebello High.
Ah, right.
Bob here's married to our Miss Sherri.
You're Sherri's husband?
Yep.
Hey, I want to shake your hand.
Oh.
See that, Bob? She's a big star.
Hey, what's it like being married to Miss Sherri?
Yeah, Bob, she make you clean up your room.
Do be a plate cleaner.
Don't be a food fussy. Don't be a teetotaler.
Do be a booze hound.
Yeah. Take it from Ray.
Take it from Ray.
You know,
Pete, can I get a small whiskey? Pete, can I get a small whiskey?
It couldn't happen here.
How do you know? Why couldn't it happen?
Because
here?
It isn't for sale
well,
here. They stopped it.
You haven't been getting it in Europe and bringing it back.
Okay, it's theoretically
you
possible.
You shouldn't write what you did. It couldn't happen here. It could. You shouldn't write that.
Well, you know something about this?
Maybe. No.
Look, Sherri. The only thing I do that's worth doing is print information that people need to know. This thalidomide thing is a real horror. If you know anyone who's gotten messed up in it, you have to tell me.
I can't.
Okay. Okay, look. No names. No recognizable details. Just the story. If this drug's gotten into this country somehow, people have to know.
Everybody gets dosed.
Everybody except Tracy. She's too little. I'm the oldest. I think I should get a whole piece of toast.
Me too.
You're not the oldest.
So it's my birthday.
It is
How do they
not.
Know this?
That's a lie.
Children.
I told them.
I want a whole piece of toast.
I'm making you a whole piece of toast.
Grandma,
you
I
told
don't
me?
Want any toast.
I just did it, Bobby. It seemed like the right thing.
Then I want two pieces.
I want two pieces, too.
Kid, you'll get your toast.
Mikey.
I told him under the condition there'd be no names.
Have you lost your mind?
You?
This is nobody else's business.
What, Bobby?
There are no names. There's no way anybody could know.
You were supposed to keep this quiet. I can't believe you did this.
Well, I did, so there.
Oh, you did it, so there. So didn't I have a right to be asked? Oh, so why don't you just tell me who else you're going to tell?
Nobody.
Mike. This is personal, private matter.
What's private?
What's an abortion?
It's nothing, honey. It's just a medical word. And I didn't tell you because I knew what you'd say. Don't tell anybody. Act like nothing's happened.
Is anyone going to tell me what we're talking about?
Well, why don't you just have a party and we can tell the whole world?
Let's have a party then.
Yeah, a party.
Oh, boy.
Who did you tell, by the way? That Crawford?
Oh, Bobby. Just eat.
This could wreck my career. This could lose me every patient I've got. My partner is just about the most prominent Catholic in town. First the Pope, then the Bishop, then Dr. Vincent Dolan.
I'm sorry about this. Do you think I like it? I'm a school teacher. I don't know what the hell Sherri thought she was doing. I mean, she wanted to warn other women or something.
Maybe she thinks she's doing something wrong. And part of her wants to get caught and punished.
You think she wants to be found out?
Well, not consciously, maybe.
I don't know. Sometimes I think women are a different species altogether, you know?
This is serious, Bob. They don't like this at Mercy Hospital. It makes them nervous. They've asked me to postpone the operation for a week while they get a legal ruling.
Postpone? What does that mean?
They're asking a court to rule that the operation is within the law.
I thought you said it was legal. I thought you said there were ways.
There's ways so long as nobody talks about it. Sherri's got it as good a case as any. As long as she doesn't tell the kids about it on the Romper Room show.
Now we can still cover the legal angle. Ray, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to call the county attorney.
Good. Hi, Sherri.
Hi, Ray.
Looking good today?
What?
Hey, terrific story just broke. Phoenix woman's abortion. I mean, it's got everything. It's got an evil drug company, court battle, mercy killing, crime, religion. I mean, it's got every damn thing.
Not everything. Hasn't got cute.
Hey, you don't know that.
She will turn out to be some overweight migrant who doesn't speak English.
It's still a great story, though. I mean, 5 years in the slammer or a monster baby. What a choice.
Bill, I want to crew down at the courthouse right away. Hang on a sec. Ray, you go down there, you nail Gillespie. If he says he's going to prosecute, you go with a mother's agony. If he says he won't, you go with respect for the law. Yeah, hi, Bill. Yeah, that's right. Two trucks. Yeah.
Well, I don't believe it.
No drug company is going to market a pill that deforms babies. How is that good business? They'd be shut down in a week.
It's true. I saw the pictures. It's so sad. These little tiny babies with no arms and no legs.
Well, if you ask me. Anthony!
Yeah!
Anthony, one more time and we are leaving. This woman read about this drug in the papers and she's using it to get rid of a baby she doesn't want.
What would you do if it were you, darling? Oh, thank God it isn't.
Whoa, Mom, watch!
I'm watching.
Yeah!
We had a Mexican maid get into trouble. No husband, of course. She did everything she could to get rid of it. I found her rolling down the stairs.
Well, it's not absolutely against the law. They do make exceptions, you know. Yeah, but it's not just about the law, is it? It's about something else. I guess so. I mean, suppose this baby already existed. No legs, no arms, whatever. Could anyone say it was right to kill it? Mm. No. Thank God it isn't me. That's all I can say.
I'd never let myself get into that position.
Anthony, let's go.
Oh, I hate that.
Are you listening? The operation's been postponed.
Postponed till when?
Next week, he said. You're not going to tell anyone else about this, are you?
No.
Okay. You see what happens when you tell people?
Yeah, it stops being a secret.
Right. It causes problems.
We're going to have to tell my mother.
You're gonna have to tell your mother.
I never heard of such a thing. Well, there was Jill Martin's daughter, but that was different.
This is gonna go on for a while, Mary. There has to be a court hearing.
Court? What for?
Well, we just have to be sure it's all okay and legal.
Jill Martin had to send her daughter away. I don't know where. She was only 16, and she never would say who the boy was, and she's still not married to this day.
I just really need help with the kids, Mom.
Of course, darling. Poor little things. I know you'll do what's right, darling. You always do.
Well, you were just terrific today, boys and girls. Oh, that's beautiful, Chris. Now remember what Mr. Doobie says and push in your chairs.
James. James. Why did you pick your nose like that? You know it doesn't look nice. Didn't you see me waving at you to stop?
The lights are so bright, Mrs. Larson can't see a thing behind the camera.
I almost died. Nobody else's kid was picking their nose.
Oh, they all do it. Just means they're relaxed.
There's such a thing as being too relaxed.
Bye-bye.
A spokesman at the Catholic Recorder in Tucson said today, any abortion breaks the fifth commandment, thou shalt not kill. This is Ray Becker, reporting from the county courthouse. For Channel 9 News.
Hello? Yes? What? I don't know what you're talking about. No, we have nothing to say. Nothing.
Birthday?
Oh, yeah, it's your birthday. Happy birthday, Mark. Come on. Shh, don't wake up your mom. Okay. Hey, Marky, did you get your dad the newspaper?
Okay.
Hello. Yeah. What? Look, we have nothing to say, all right?
Thanks. Welcome. It's my birthday, Mommy.
It sure is. Oh, happy birthday, Marky.
Did you get me a bicycle?
Oh, I don't know. Did we get him a bicycle, Bobby?
Sure.
Oh, my God.
Did you?
Honey, he promised no names.
Did you?
They've even got a right dress in here.
There's a slew of reporters outside. I just got a call from CBS in New York.
Did you?
Bobby, what are we going to do?
Did you?
Yes, honey, we got your bike. Go get dressed, and after breakfast, you'll get your presents.
Mom!
Honey, nobody's even up yet.
I'm awake. That's an important part.
Mark, go get dressed. There's no presents till you get dressed.
Fine. What are we going to do, Bobby?
What are we going to do? We do nothing. And we say nothing. That's what got us in trouble in the first place.
What do they want?
Oh, never mind what they want. Who do they think they are ringing bells like that?
Red, Red, I want it red!
Hey, Red. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Marky.
Bye.
But I don't ride in the street. Oh, darling, we forgot to sing happy birthday.
Oh, do it tonight, Mom.
Oh. Daddy, when I get when it's my birthday, I want a bike like that, only pink. Birthday.
It's your birthday, huh?
Mm-hmm.
What's your name?
Mark.
Did you get a new bike for your birthday?
Yeah.
How's your mommy, Mark?
She's fine.
Yeah? She been feeling kind of sad lately?
I don't know.
No? She been crying?
Why are you asking me all these questions?
I'm a friend of your mommy's. I just want to know how she's doing.
There she is!
Hey, how old is
Let's
she?
Let's go! Come on! Abortion mother is Miss Sherri on a bombshell! Would you make a comment, please?
Mark, get
him
out! I just don't think it's true, yeah.
Hi, Jack.
Hi there.
Sherri.
Hi, Marty.
Morning.
But you didn't think I'd make it today, did you? Candy cat. You knew I wouldn't forget you.
Nobody forgets me, sister. I'm the star.
Sherri, the big boss wants to see you in the control room now.
Mr. Zinner, this has absolutely nothing to do with my work here at the station.
It does have something to do with it, Sherri.
I've won 2 Emmys. You have them right out there in your glass case. You seem pretty pleased to have me around then.
I know what you're saying,
Sherri. I'm having a bad time now, Mr. Zinner. I'm good at my job. And I need it.
All right, Linda.
Don't make it any harder for me.
Addition, multiplication, and subtraction. Oh, that's very good, Candy Cat. Can you hear me well enough? Can I do that? Or do I have to be louder?
I thought it'd be a good idea to get Linda into cover.
Oh, yes, Linda.
You just couldn't wait, could you?
You don't seem to appreciate...
You expect me to appreciate that?
You know how it is. We can't even say the word pregnant on TV. You want to have an abortion and go on doing the show? Sherri, it's over. Our viewers won't accept you working with children. Not anymore.
Excellent. Excellent rehearsal, Linda.
Thank you.
Okay, let's try it one more time.
Oh, you're so cute.
Mom, look, Miss Sherri.
I hope they lock you up and throw away the key. What am I supposed to do? Just tell me what I'm supposed to do!
Hang on,
what's
your mind?
Hey, Sherri,
drop this
big guy,
please.
Sherri,
quick shot.
Come on, Sherri. Sherri, please. Sherri, just run away. Sherri, please. Come on.
Just be quiet. Just one thing.
Come on.
Sherri,
please.
Come on.
It's all right, everybody. I'm okay.
Want to be on TV? Gonna be on TV?
Get away from the window.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh. Is that Mama? Is that my name?
Where's Bob?
He's at school.
Not him.
Mom, what is there's him? A man. Look.
Oh, hon.
Wait.
Bedtime.
Bob, you got a minute?
Oh, yeah, sure, Frank, come on in.
I'm sorry about all this, Bob.
Oh, well.
You know, if I was in your position, I'd do exactly what you're doing. I can't say that in public. I know you understand that, but I want you to know.
Well, thank you, Frank. I mean, I appreciate that. I really do.
How's Sherri?
Well, she's taking it pretty hard, you know? About how you expect.
I think you should be home with her, Bob.
For how long?
Well, just until it all settles.
And what about after that?
Well, let's see how it goes. Okay? Stay until the end of the week.
Mr. Finkbine, we
have
a statement.
Come on, guys, whose car is this?
Hey, whose car is it? Jeff, give the gentleman a break.
I can't even get my own driveway now.
Mr. Finkbine, Randall Everett, CanBS TV, sir.
Mr. Finkbine, we have our cameras right here, sir.
Could you make your wife come outside? Could you make her talk to us, sir? Mr. Finkbine, you and your wife deserve a chance to tell your own story in your own way.
I'd like that.
Look, if the hospital rules against you, will she go ahead and have the baby? Mr. Finkbine, tell it on TV. Okay, you won't get misquoted. Will you be suing the drug company? Tell your story.
I'll talk to Sherri, okay?
Tell it on TV. It'll give you a chance to clear up all the misunderstandings.
All right, all right. Listen, guys. Will you back off, please? This is really tough on Sherri, okay? Just back off, okay?
One more shot, sir.
Yes.
Hi.
Oh, hi, Bobby.
Hey, Tracy. Oh, that court hearing? It's set for Monday.
Do I have to be there?
No. It's up to the judge. It looks like I could lose my job over this.
Oh, Bobby.
Well, I just lost mine.
You did?
Yeah.
Oh, I had a feeling. I'm sorry. I know that show means a lot.
Well, it's not just that. We need the $75 a week. Could they really fire you?
I didn't think so, but now, I don't know.
Dottie Harper called. Joy's got an ear infection, won't be able to come to swimming lessons for a while.
Mm-hmm. Could be a lot of ear infections going around.
Maybe Mom could help us.
Listen, I don't want you worrying about money. That's my job. I'll figure something out.
Say goodbye to Ducky, darling. Oh, Tom Crawford didn't tell him my name. The hospital did.
The hospital?
Yeah, when they were applying for the court ruling, they had to give my name and address.
Who told you that?
Tom. I called him. He felt just terrible about it.
Oh, well, poor Tom. Is he going to lose his job?
Come on, darling. Come on. Come on. I don't know what I've done that all this is happening to us.
Oh, that. I just wish you hadn't told me.
Oh, I know. Me too.
You know what? Those men outside are still there. What do they want?
You remember how babies are made? How they start from a seed inside the mommy's tummy and that seed grows into a baby? And you know how when you get sick, you take medicine, like if you have a cold or something. Well, I took some medicine, some pills. Only they were bad pills.
How were they bad?
Well, they were bad because when I took them, I was starting to make a baby. And the bad pills hurt the baby.
What did they do?
They...
What your mom's really trying to say is that there isn't going to be a baby.
Sometimes that happens. A baby starts to grow and then something happens and...
Did the baby die?
No, honey, the baby didn't die.
And it isn't a baby yet. It's just a little seed right now.
But it'll grow into a baby.
Well, your daddy and I talked to a doctor. And he thinks the seed should be taken out.
So that's what we're going to do. We're going to take it out.
Is the baby bad?
No, honey. The pills are bad.
Why do they all want to know about us?
Because I don't know, honey. That's just... It's the way people are. Nobody was supposed to know.
Who cares who knows? Doesn't make it wrong just because people get to know about it.
Well, that's how it feels. Now, you want some coffee?
I want to know how it happened. Now, Dennis and I were wondering, why would Bob, of all people, be taking tranquilizers?
Oh, remember when Bob took that school group to London last summer? He wasn't sleeping well, and the doctor prescribed tranquilizers. So when I wasn't sleeping well this last month, that's it. End of story. Is that such a terrible thing to do?
No.
Do I have to pay for it the rest of my life? And then I tell the press. Why did I do that, Diane? That's what's driving me crazy. Why did I do that?
Because you wanted people to know.
Oh, and they're all so upset with me. Everybody wanted to keep it a secret. Bob, Dr. Werner, Pete Zenner, everybody.
But you don't.
You just tell it in your own way, Mrs. Finkbine. Hey, I'm only here so you have somebody to look at. Sorry I'm not any prettier. Okay, great. Both ready?
Yeah.
Rolling. Speed.
Mrs. Finkbine, going back a few days now, were you happy you were pregnant before you found out about thalidomide?
Oh, yeah, I love kids.
So you were all set to have your fifth child before you knew?
Yeah, sure.
I guess you had some names lined up.
Names?
Names for the new baby.
Oh, gosh, yeah. Well, it was going to be Bob Jr. if it was a boy, and then Lisa if it was a girl.
And then you learned there was a great likelihood your baby would be born severely deformed.
Yes.
A lot of people are laying down the law about what you should do and you shouldn't do. But in the end, you're the one who has to make this decision, you and only you.
Yes.
And what is that decision?
To go ahead with the operation, legally, on the advice of my doctor.
Now, you say an operation, and we're talking about an abortion, right? And that must be a very hard decision to make.
Yeah.
What does it feel like to decide to kill your own baby?
What? What the hell kind of a question is that?
That's what an abortion is, isn't it?
We're talking about a fetus.
Well, isn't a fetus a baby?
No, it sure as hell is not. You know what? Turn that off. This show is over. You get your crew and get your camera and get the hell out of my house.
Bob, I didn't mean to...
Well, you upset me. And you upset my wife. What?
We told them their names.
Yeah?
You told them the names.
So?
I don't want it to have a name, don't you know that? True that you have to quit?
Yeah, just for a little while, I hope.
Why?
I don't know, Mary Beth. I guess that's just how it is.
You leaving today?
No, I'm gonna be here till the end of the week.
Well, I guess there's no way I can make it any better for you, but if there was a way, I would do it.
Oh, that's very sweet. How's things at home?
Like always.
Take care of yourself, Mary.
You too.
Tricycle. Ice cream sandwich.
What kind of ice cream?
She'll pay for it. Drumstick?
Fudgesicle, please.
Fudgesicle, there
you go. I know about your mom. What about her? She's going to jail.
She's not.
She's a baby killer.
She's not.
My mom says she can wiggle her ass all she likes, but she's still a baby killer.
Hey, stop. Stop it right now.
Hold on.
She started it.
I did not.
Sandra's calling Terry's mom bad names.
I hate her.
Okay, let's go see her. Come on. It's okay, Angel.
It's all right.
Everything's okay now.
I hate her. Mommy. I hate her.
Mommy. Diane said she didn't think anybody really got hurt.
You're not a baby killer.
No, honey, of course I'm not.
Good morning.
Good morning. It looks like you got popular.
My gracious.
Yeah, mostly crazies, I'd say.
Oh?
Yeah. See, here's a crazy. Green ink, capital letters, double underline, can't spell. That's a crazy, all right.
Oh, is it?
Personally, I don't hold with this mercy killing. But like I say, you know, live and let live.
I don't think you're listening to me. Yeah, all right, I'll read some of these to you. Why don't you take your other four kids and strangle them, too? I'd be careful in the dark if I were you. You think you can kill your baby without people doing something about it? There's a picture here of my wife with her eyes gouged out. This just goes on like this. We know where you live. We're going to come after you, you murderers. I mean, we'll get your kids. Well, yeah, they sure look serious to me. These are crazy people. Crazy people do crazy things.
Well, yes, exactly. That's what I'm asking. Thank you. We would really appreciate that, yes. Okay. Great. Thanks.
I called the police. I told them we needed protection. They put me on to the FBI.
I brought you some aspirin.
I don't want any.
Aspirin can't hurt you.
That's what they said about tranquilizers.
My poor baby.
Oh, Mom.
Tell him to leave me alone.
Tell him to stop being mean to me.
You leave my little girl alone, you hear? She's a good girl.
What am I gonna do?
You have to do what you think's best, darling. I guess you've thought about adoption?
Yeah, I've thought about it.
It's just that I was thinking, you remember Frieda Ziegler and the deaf and dumb boy she took in? She had no one, and she loved him so much. No one could understand him. He made such funny noises, but she could.
Mom, if I had this baby, I could never.
People do.
Well, how could I live my life knowing it was out there somewhere?
You've got Bob, darling. I'm sure the two of you will work it out.
It's okay. It's okay. I just wanted to talk to you.
For God's sake, Mary Beth, you can't just ride around in my car.
Well, nobody knows. Oh. Nobody saw me get in.
Oh.
You scared the hell out of me, Mary Beth.
Sorry.
So, you wanted to talk to me, or what's going on?
You're having a hard time, right?
Right. So what?
So I can help. You know, if you just let me. You help me. It's only fair.
Look, Mary Beth.
It's just that you look so sad, you know? I hate to see you look so sad.
Look, Mary Beth.
I only want to make you feel better.
Mary Beth, this isn't a good idea.
No, nobody has to know. Just you and me. It's okay, you know. Just so long as nobody knows. I love you. Just let me love you.
No more. I'm gonna drive you home. Right now.
You mad at me?
No, I'm mad at myself.
Doctor, is a fetus a baby?
Once the fetus is capable of living outside the womb, that is a viable human being.
Which is when?
About 28 weeks.
That's interesting. Now, in the Finkbine case, we are talking 9 or 10 weeks, right?
That's my understanding, yes.
Doctor, can you tell us a little bit about how developed a fetus is at that point?
Well, between 8 and 12 weeks, the embryo grows from 1 to 3 inches long.
This is getting out of control. I can't take the heat.
Al, now you brought us this lady. Does she have a good case for termination?
Yes, yes, yes.
I think so, too. So we'll hang together.
Look, every time the woman steps out the door, the story gets bigger and bigger. She's just too photogenic.
How is she handling that?
That's not the point. The point is she keeps yapping her mouth off to everybody.
All right. I will admit her to the hospital today.
Ahead of the court ruling?
Absolutely. We'll just do it under another name.
Okay. Good.
Oh, am I in the right place?
Sure are. We thought you might be more comfortable coming in this way. Just right down the hall here.
Hi. I'm Steve Morris, the hospital administrator. One of the few people who knows you're here. It seems that everybody in the world wants to know all about you, but I'll see to it that you're not bothered here.
What did you say your name was?
Steve Morris.
I can't afford this, Mr. Morris.
Don't worry about it. The hospital will pick up the check. It's better for everybody if you're out of circulation for a while.
I'm contagious.
You're not the only one, Mrs. Finkbine. We do a lot of terminations here.
Then why am I...
Because you've been open about it all, I guess.
I can do it if I think I'm wrong. But if I'm right, I have to be stopped.
I know it sounds crazy, but it's a crazy world we live in.
Late this afternoon, the court refused to rule in the controversial Sherri Finkbine case. It's up to the doctors, says the judge. Mrs. Sherri Finkbine has been the hostess of the Romper Room show since late 1958, shortly after moving to Phoenix from Dumas, Texas. A graduate from the University of Wisconsin in Madison, Mrs. Finkbine started her career doing local television commercials. She and her husband, Bob, a high school teacher here in Phoenix, have four children, Terry, Mark, Steve, and Tracy.
Why, Terry?
And when's now, mommy coming home?
Soon, from darling. Just as soon as she's better. You want her to get better, don't you?
There is no obscurity in the law. An abortion may only be performed when the continuation of the pregnancy puts the mother's life at risk.
Let's tuck you back.
Do you think Mrs. Finkbine's abortion is against the law? Is her life at risk? I'm not a doctor. That's a medical judgment. Do you feel sympathy for Mrs. Finkbine? As a human being, I would like to hear this case. As a judge, under existing Arizona law, I cannot.
Now let's hear from the administrator of Mercy Hospital.
Mr. Morris, your opinion, please. Does Mrs. Finkbine qualify for an abortion?
In my opinion, Mrs. Finkbine has grounds for termination as good as or better than any of the ones we've already performed. The hospital's medical council will meet tomorrow morning to decide.
Mr. Morris, when will you release it?
We have to consider the effect this could have on the reputation of the hospital.
How much of this stuff do we do around here anyway?
300 or 400 a year.
300 a year? One a day? Jesus, I had no idea.
Well, why should you? You're orthopedics.
I don't like it.
It's a little late for that now.
I never did like it.
Well, you never said so before.
Do you do this?
Sure. Well, what do you expect me to do? Send him down to the back streets to die?
How much do you charge?
What's that got to do with anything?
Well, that's the kind of thing people say.
And you operate for free, do you?
At least my operations are necessary.
I don't believe this.
Hey, now let's get back on track here. This is a woman in need and a lousy law.
It may be a lousy law, but it's the law and we are not above it. Listen, I'm as willing as the next guy to go to jail on a point of principle. But what kind of moral crusade is abortion, for Christ's sake?
Nothing, sir.
They said no.
It was close, but I'm sorry.
Huh. They think I'm wrong. They think I shouldn't do it. It's that simple.
It's not that. If they were challenged to their decision, they could all go to jail.
They don't want to be called murderers or baby killers. I'm going home. I'm not going to stay here.
Come on, Bobby. Let's go home. I want to see the babies.
I'll have the baby. Spend the rest of my life taking care of him like everybody wants. And everybody will say, isn't she wonderful? We'll have to save up for a trust fund, so after we're dead, he can live in a home or someplace. It's just the way I have to be.
Our friends.
Sherri, we continue to take abortion.
Hey, leave her alone.
Hey, this way.
Who are you?
FBI, ma'am.
We're here to protect your family.
Oh. Fine. Are you staying for dinner?
Oh, no, ma'am. We'll be going outside right now.
Where'd you go, Mommy?
Not too loud. You wake the baby. They're Don and Jerri. Don's got two children, and Jerry's engaged to a nurse.
You got real guns, Mom.
Well, I'm going to go fix dinner. It's dinner time.
How
long are you guys gonna be here? Are you gonna leave with us? We just had some dinner and watched some TV. Go to bed.
Dr. Warner? Dr. Warner?
Is Sherri going ahead with the abortion, doctor?
Not that I know of, because the hospital turned her down.
Does that mean she's going to have the baby?
If she doesn't have an abortion, that does seem a probable outcome. Look, doctor, I'm just here as a friend of the family to help out. Do me a favor, will you, boys? Don't use my name, okay? Excuse me.
Thank you, fellas.
Is she better now? I mean, why was she sick?
Well, she's home, right? So she must be better.
All right, come on. It's madness. Won't they ever go away? No. Come on, sit down.
Oh, I see.
Wow, those guys are like sharks.
Have a seat. Oh, so... what's the story? Well, basically, we've got two options. There's the private clinics with
qualified doctors. Expensive, but safe.
How expensive?
$1,000, maybe. The only thing is, they're probably not going to want the publicity either. So,
what's the second option there?
Well, it's not really an option. It's there's the back alley boys. Doctors have lost their licenses, and the ones who do quickies for prostitutes, 5 minutes with a coat hanger, $50.
Why didn't you tell me Dr. Warner was here?
You were asleep, honey.
How do you know? Did you come and see?
I didn't want to disturb you.
This is my baby. This is my baby. Why didn't anybody ever ask me?
Okay, I'm sorry. I thought you needed the rest. I thought you were asleep.
How could you even talk about it without me? How could you do that?
Look, Bob just wants to protect you.
I can't stand it, all you men. You're just having all these meetings. That's me you're talking about. Judges and doctors and lawyers.
Okay, all right. Now you ease up now, honey. The kids are right there.
Let me give you something to relax you, Sherri.
I don't want anything. Poppy, this is me that has to do this. Me. Not you.
Look, let's be calm here. There may be a way.
What?
Well, there are other countries.
It's legal in other countries?
Some. Japan, Switzerland, Sweden. I can make some calls.
That's what Sherri wants. Sherri? Sherri. Shutting me out. Okay, fine. Just don't ever talk to me the way you talk to me in front of Dr. Werner, okay? Do me that favor. I hate that. This is my baby, too.
I know that.
So why would you say that? It has nothing to do with me?
You don't feel it the way I do. It didn't hurt for you the way it hurts for me. Didn't get to you.
I am just not letting it get to me.
Why?
Because some one of us has to see a way through this. I'm just not letting my emotions get out of proportion.
Mommy, this is gonna hurt me for the rest of my life, whatever I do. Tell me what's the right proportion for that.
Honey, that is not true. We will get through this.
You will. You're still 16 inside somewhere, aren't you, Bobby? Still one of the guys, still dating the prettiest girls.
Okay, fine. What do you mean, dating?
Nothing. I just mean I'm alone on this one, that's all.
Baloney. I'm right here. And yes, I like my job, and I'm good at it. I understand my students, and they respond to that. What the hell is wrong with that? Yeah, there's a danger there. Sometimes students get crushes on teachers. I don't ask for it. It's not my fault. I don't encourage it. But it happens.
What?
This student of mine. I'm old enough to be her father.
You're old enough to be this one's father, too.
Thank you. work on the weekend.
I knew you would say that. Hi, Sherri. Come on in.
Oh, hi, Sherri.
Come on, sit down.
Yeah, here. Have a seat. I'll go check on the kids.
The hospital won't do it.
I heard.
Well, maybe I should have the baby.
Is that what you want?
I don't know how to handle it. You good?
Oh, since when am I Miss Wonderful?
What would you do if it were you? How would you face it?
You mean if I was gonna have...
Yeah.
Well, I'd pray a lot at the start. And then I guess I'd think about it. And I'd decide that somehow this was God's plan for me, that there had to be something good in it. And then I'd talk to Dennis and we'd make plans because, I mean, it would change everything. Some things that we dreamed of doing, we just have to forget about. Maybe other things would take their place, things that I don't know about yet. The kids would all have to pitch in. That would be hard on them in many ways, but maybe they'd get something from it. I don't know what.
I mean, there are people with all kinds of handicaps, and they have jobs and lives and families.
You'd be a saint, Diane, I know you.
Who's being a saint? Anyone can talk.
Well, you think about Dennis, you think about the kids, you think about God. The only one you don't think about is yourself.
I'm no one special.
It's not true.
So was I any help?
Yeah.
Where'd you go, Diane's?
Yeah. Did the kids get to bed okay?
Yes, well, but of course they wanted you, and we didn't know what to tell them.
Well, I wasn't gone very long, Mom.
Bob won't tell me what's happened, so I don't understand, so I don't know what to say. I'm sorry.
I told you nothing's happened. We're waiting. That's it. End of message, Mary.
Whatever anyone says against Sherri, she's never been one to put herself before others. Even when she was little, all she wanted was to make other people happy. You did, Sherri. I'm not saying that just because I'm your mother. Peter was never like that. You never thought of yourself. If there was just the one fudge brownie left, you'd want Peter to have it, or one of your little friends. I was so proud of you, and I'll tell you what. It made everybody love you. You were my best girl, do you remember?
That's what's wrong, Mom.
You were, darling.
I'm not your best girl. I'm not anybody's best girl.
What I'm saying is you're a good person, Sherri. I don't care what anyone else says.
Best girls don't kill their babies, do they, Mom?
Sherri.
Best girls grow up to be good mothers. Isn't that right? I don't take the last fudge brownie. That's where everybody loves me.
I don't know what you want me to say. Do you want me to say you're doing something bad? I won't say that. I know you're thinking of the children. And Bob, you're thinking of Bob.
What if I'm thinking of myself, Mom?
Oh, do we have to do this now?
Do best mothers think of themselves, Mom, do they?
Of course they do.
Then why did you tell me about Frieda Siegler and the deaf and dumb boy?
I was just reminded.
I'm not Frieda Siegler. I'm not Diane. I can't do it, Mom. Why would you understand that?
I've always been proud of you. Is that wrong? I mean, I think it's wonderful if...
Mom,
I mean,
please listen to
me. If a mother can be proud of her child.
Mom, just listen to me.
Okay, okay, I'm listening.
Remember the pearl earrings Grandma gave you? Remember how one of them got lost and you looked everywhere for it and Dad got angry because it made you late and he shouted at you?
Yes, I remember. We never did find it.
Well, I took it, Mom. I took it to try it on. I tried on your makeup, too. I was looking at myself in the bathroom mirror, and it fell off and went down the drain.
You were only little.
You never know about me and Gary Shearer either.
Gary Shearer?
You never knew what I was really like, Mom.
Gary was a nice boy.
I was never as good as you thought I was, Mom. I tried to be. I just wasn't.
Why are you telling me all this, Sherri? Don't you want me to be proud of you?
You're not proud of me, Mom. You're proud of what a good mother you've been.
Haven't I been a good mother?
I didn't say that, Mom.
I've done my best.
I know that.
I may not be perfect.
You don't understand what I'm saying.
I've loved you as best as
I know that.
Don't you want me to love you?
No, I don't! Not like this!
All right, you two, that is enough. Sherri, you've got to get some sleep.
She's done this before. This is just what she did when she was 2 years old, these sudden tantrums. I never understood them.
No, you never did.
I was always so proud of my kids. I always said, my kids love me. I got that one right, at least. My Sherri loves me, I always said.
I do love you, Mom. But can I love myself, too?
Mark, you don't have cookies for breakfast.
Why not?
Stevie, eat your cereal, please, darling.
Would you like some cookies?
No, ma'am, coffee's fine.
I want some cookies. You can't have cookies for breakfast, Mark.
Eat your cereal, darling, please.
I'll tell you what to do. You're the boss.
Okay, oh, boy. Yes, yeah, would you do that?
So, you know what this is all about?
Okay.
Well, we've been briefed.
Right. Please.
Well, what do you think about it?
Yeah, I'll be right here.
You mean like personally?
I don't know anymore.
Mark, we do as you're told.
Your personal feelings don't come into it, ma'am. You get an assignment, you do it. Like a couple of months ago, Jerry and I were doing a 24-hour protection of a Negro family.
We get all sorts in our line of business.
They had threats, same as you.
Oh, why were they threatened?
Why?
Up you go.
Well, black kids, white school. You know, cute little kids, though, huh?
Hmm. Couldn't make out a word they said.
When are you and the nurse getting married?
Good question.
It's all over the papers in Japan. They won't do it. He's trying, sweetie.
Look at Mr. No Face.
Good
What are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing?
It's the middle of the night. Did you cut that out? You're gonna wake up the kids. It
drives me crazy the way nothing ever fits anymore. Why do they sell these things?
Sherri, we do not need to do this now.
It's not like it's a spaceship, for Christ's sake. It's just a swing set. You think they could get it right? Okay. This is a crossbar. Right. Goes in here. Right? God, I want it. Go!
Just put that down. It is 3 o'clock in the morning. I'll do it tomorrow.
What am I doing wrong? Bobby, are you going to help me here?
Sherri, have you heard a word I said?
This takes two people, Bobby. She's gonna have to hold one in for me.
Not healthy. You put up a swing set in the middle of the night.
Let go of me!
You're not the only one having a hard time here, Sherri. Try thinking about other people for a change. I know that's hard for you, being as you're the center of the universe, but just try, okay?
Walk away, Bob! That's my Bob! Here comes the shit! There goes Bobby walking away! Keep walking, Bobby! You know how to do it! You can't take the shit, can you, Bobby?
Shut your mouth, Sherri.
Come on, run and hide, Bobby! You can't take it, can you?
Shut up!
You don't have to deal with this. Go on, hide your head under a pillow, Bobby. Maybe all the shit will go away and then you won't have to think about it anymore, Bobby! Go on, Bobby!
Shut the hell
what
up!
What are you...
Shut
away.
Up! Shut the hell up!
You want to hit me, Bobby? Huh? Want to hit me?
Oh.
Come on, Bobby! Hit me, Bobby!
Shut
Come
up.
On, hit me! Hit me, Bobby!
Oh, Sherri, shut up!
Hit the baby, Bobby! Hit the baby! Come on, Bobby!
I don't want to hit the baby. I want to kill it. I want to rip it out and kill it. Oh, God. I can't. I'm sorry. Oh, God, help me.
I can't
fight like this anymore. I'm sorry.
That's okay. It's okay.
Oh,
I love you.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. We do again,
Bobby. Yeah, so I'm standing there in the middle of the sunrise.
Really
fun. Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
Let me see that one more time.
Here comes a taxi, boys.
Yeah, look. Mr.
Finkbine, will you be accompanying your wife to Sweden?
Mr. Finkbine, how much left for you to talk?
Miss Sherri, what made you choose Sweden? Miss Sherri, have you felt the baby move yet?
How long will you guys be gone, Mr. Finkbine? What are you running for?
He's running for the air of the hospital.
Guys,
how do you feel about leaving the country, Mr. Finkbine? Is this a day of
protection? You're going to touch all the way, Mr. Sherri.
You stay with the kids. What are you running for? A lot of people think what you're doing is wrong. What do you say to them?
You're not going to get it right here.
Don't ever go through what I'm going through. Will you let us go now?
Hey, that's enough, guys.